Happy Friday, everyone. Guys, if this Friday review, whatever we call this little intro thing, fails, I'm just going to start calling these Fail Fridays. So today, we will not be doing anything dangerous or anything messy. It does not involve water or fire. I actually saw under party, I looked up party tricks again, and I saw where this guy used a kitchen dish towel to make a chicken. So it looks like a raw chicken, like you'd use in the kitchen, not like a walking around living chicken, but a food chicken. So I thought it was only fitting to use my kitchen dish towel, and I have my little table set up on top of a pelican case. It's barely bigger than my table, so there may be some wobbling, but here we go. I saw a little video, and basically it looked like the guy took his dish towel and he rolled it up long ways in the center towards itself. So I don't know what the halfway mark is. This might be a lopsided chicken. I feel like I rolled it a lot more on the other side. Maybe I'll just be a bully with this side and push it over. Okay, so there is my rolled dish towel. And then he flipped it over. And my table's not big enough for my giant dish towel. He grabbed the center of his rolls, each one with a different hand. Oh, this is more tricky than I thought. Okay, and then he folded it in half long ways and grabbed the other side. I'm not sure if he grabbed the centers of this side too, but I'm assuming he did. Again, this is not that easy. Of the rolled towel, and then he pulled it up like this, and his table didn't fall like mine. I'm gonna go ahead and move this out of the way, and then we'll try this in a second. So he held it up, and then he split it apart, and oh, what did he do from here? Did he just hold it like, nope, that wasn't it. Guys, I feel like I'm really close. I'm gonna try that again. I'm just gonna do it in my lap this time. Okay, let's try this again. Split it in half, and then was it like this? maybe it was like, oh guys, I think I did it again. I think it was like this, but mine doesn't quite look like a chicken. It sort of looks like the letter H. So from any of my sides, it looks like the letter H or a mess. It looks like a dish towel that I rolled up and pulled apart. Okay, yep, another fail. Whatever. Let me move some of the stuff around and then we will get into our review. So Monday started out a little crazy. I had actually filmed an entire video, and then when I went to go edit it, my editing software would not let me upload it. Like, it would let me upload it, but it wouldn't completely upload. It would only upload like the first minute and 6 seconds, which for me is just me sitting down in the chair getting ready to talk. So there was no footage at all. And a refilm. So I ended up using two scriptures as the scripture of the day. One of them was Psalms 46:5, and it says, God is in the midst of her. She will not be moved. God will help her when the morning dawns. And then Proverbs 31:25, she is clothed with strength and dignity. She laughs without fear of the future. And I said my reasoning for those two were they were really great strength building scriptures that you could just remind yourself in hard times. In the video, I go on to talk about a quote that I got from my pastor that said, emotions are not good leaders, but they're great followers. And I use that to talk about how we can't use our emotions to justify our actions, and how we need to remember that our circumstances are what influence our emotions, but as Christians, we have strength to not be influenced by our circumstances, that we have to remind ourselves that God has a plan for our circumstances, and his plans don't end in failure. So we can draw joy from that and not be overcome by our emotions. We remind our emotions that God has a way out for us, so those emotions don't have to consume us. Tuesday's scripture was Galatians 6:9, and it says, let us not grow weary of doing what is good. In just the right time, we will reap the harvest of blessing if we don't give up. And then Tuesday's video was inspired by two different quotes. One of them was, you can't receive the truth, unless you're aware of the lies. And the other one was, life is not about the pursuit of happiness. It's about joy in the pursuit of God. And these quotes got me thinking about the lie that I had believed. I thought that I was going to get to this point in my life where bad things were going to stop happening. And when I looked at the Bible, there was no example of this. In fact, it was the exact opposite. And looking at these examples, I realized that these people kept their joy because they trusted in God that He had a way out for them. And that's the promise that we have. On Wednesday, I had some bad news, and I was just having an overall bad day. And when I sat down to read chapters 3 and 4 of You Can, You Will, I was so encouraged. The chapters were actually titled Expect Good Things and Having a Positive Mindset. In that video, I just shared how the things that I read that day helped me so much and just reaffirmed what God has already been laying in my heart with staying positive and how expecting good things isn't being naive, but it's releasing your faith. Then Thursday's scripture was Proverbs 3:6, and it says, "Seek His will in all you do, and He will show you which path to take." And I didn't do a big encouraging video on Thursday. It was super, super short. And I just talked about how I was still struggling with the news I had received the day before. And I just finally decided to sit down and write myself an encouraging letter. And I told you guys that if you're struggling, you should do the same, where you take yourself out of the situation and you write yourself a letter as if it were to a friend in your situation, and just how you would encourage that person and how great it is to be able to go back to that and read that every single day and remind yourself that this is how you should view the situation. And so guys, this week was a struggle for me, and I just want to share a little bit about why I started this channel. And I didn't just start it because I was like, hey, I want to go on YouTube and be famous, or any kind of like selfish motivation like that. I really felt it in my heart, and I just kept thinking, this is a selfish idea. This is me just wanting attention. Like, I don't know why I keep having this dream of having a YouTube channel. And I finally got to the point where I was like, okay, God, I really feel like you're telling me to do this. I'm going to do it. And when I did it, I didn't feel like I knew what I was doing. And I was just trying to put out something that was entertaining. And I got to the point where I really felt like God was telling me to stop. I had a video planned for Valentine's Day, and to be honest, it was a video mocking a famous person, and it was going to be funny, but it did not portray godly character, and I really felt like God did not want me to film that video, and there were actual obstacles that came up that kept me from filming that video. And so I stopped, and I gotten to this point where I was posting consistently on Mondays, and so I was just like, well, God, you told me to start this channel and I need something for Monday. And I just kind of like threw the pressure back to God. Like, he's, you know, like he's just gonna listen to me and be like, oh, I'm so sorry. Let me give you some content for Monday. Let me let you do something against my will so that you can post a video on Monday for the channel that I told you to start. Anyways, guys, if that's any light to my relationship with God or my personality, there you go. But I spent some time in prayer and I was really just seeking God, and I was kind of irritated with him, like, okay, what do you want me to do? Now I look like this failure who isn't posting. And that's when God laid it on my heart to start this daily show. And basically what he told me was to start the day out with a scripture and post daily videos. And I was so overwhelmed at first. I was like, how am I going to post daily videos? I'm barely making Monday videos. So I was like, okay, I'm going to be obedient and I'm going to try this. And it has turned out to be such a blessing to me to be able to go back and watch these things that God is putting in my heart to tell people, and continuing to seek Him and ask Him, like, what should I say? What do I talk about? Like, I struggle with my own security, and who am I to say anything? I'm no expert. I'm, you know, I didn't finish any kind of Bible classes, or I did start some, but I never finished any of them. And, you know, like, I'm not an expert in anything. Like, who am I that I know anything about anything? And the answer I felt that God gave me was, what would you tell them about me? And so that's what I've come on here to do, is if I had a room full of people and I had to tell them something about God. This is what I would share. This is what I wish somebody would tell me instead of going through this, which I know that this is my path. And I honestly, I probably wouldn't trade it because it is what's encouraged my faith and what has strengthened me. But through this, I know I don't have a ton of people watching, and that doesn't discourage me because I've been able to go back through these videos and they've been an encouragement to myself. So I am just really, really, I say this a lot, but I'm excited about this channel and I'm excited about what God's doing. And I'm so thankful for each and every one of you that watch these and are here with me and you're going on this journey with me. And so I just wanted to let you guys know, I know I've never formally said it on my channel and I didn't want to make a big video about it because I didn't feel like it really had a place on my channel, so I thought I'd just tag it on to the end of this Friday review. I guess you guys who watch Friday review will always get extra little tidbits and behind the scenes information. So that is your little behind the scenes tidbit for this week. Thank you so much again and I will see you guys next week.